friends. Good morning to you. It's me, the Drifter. Listen, I just got word Myrtle pulled in with a couple of cord on. It's freezing these mornings out. Now get your hoodies in there and your t-shirts. It's hot to trot. BuckandBillyRay.com. Don't miss out. They're flip-flopping, flying right out of there. Drift on.
Let's climb. Well, friends, as the colder months come, we spend more time in this bunker. Johnny Holmgren, for those of you who don't know who Johnny Holmgren is, Holmgren, he is a fellow who received a gift from this channel. I bought a 562. Husky, brand new, right out of the shop, right out of Walker's showroom. Just boom, bang, I'll take it. I want to try this saw. I've heard good things about it. I bought it, tried it, played around with it, a couple different sprocket sizes, and then we gave it away because I don't run mid-size saws. I haven't for years. I bought a 357, a 346. Used them for some stuff, but I use a topping saw and a 372. And big bucking saws. I don't use mid-size saws. I'm not that guy. I never have been, friends. To me, if you're chunking out a tree, I'm running a 372 with a 24-inch bar, and I'll be down that tree way quicker than a fella using anything smaller than that, because there's just so much power. And you're never really packing the saw. It's either on top of the tree or in the wood. That's how I see it. Anyways, friends, I'm going to make this, that's a 5.5 pound head, and I'm going to put it on a French curve. I'm putting it on one of these. And the reason I'm doing that is because look at the size of the eye. It's massive. But guess what? Look, I've already got it drawn out. It's going on here, and we're doing it. That's what we're doing. I'm excited about it, actually. There's some neat things developing right now by a very unsuspecting gentleman. It's about opportunities. That's one thing that it is about. Josh Hickey, him and his wife, just nice folk, nice freaking folks. Here, I'm just going to put you guys in here, friends. I want to share this build with you, this axe build, because it's a different specimen, actually. I almost feel like putting the fire on, but I'm not going to because I'm going to start working. Look at Mr. Josh Hickey. Look what Mr. Josh Hickey's got coming for me, friends. Look at this. And I mean, I'm talking, he's just about ready. He's just, Nick Pixel. Nick, once again, community, friends. Community. Josh is getting his website, his LLC. He's going into the handle business. And he told me straight to me, he said, Buckin, you are never going to have to worry about axe handles again. I've heard all kinds of things through the years, friends. And that is one thing that I enjoyed hearing, I'll tell you. So anyways, I've heard all kinds of stuff, right? So you just, oh, sure, okay, sounds good, Josh. Well, friends, Josh is a man of his word. Thus far, he has produced handles. Remember what he said, friends, on the live? He said, Buckin, I'm going to give you your first 100 handles. That is our gift to you for what you've done for us, which I don't know what that is. I think it's what the community's done for them. I don't like taking credit for that stuff. But anyways, so we've got handles for the wood bullet. And I want to thank Whiskey River. I reached out to Whiskey River. I loved his bigger 32-inch handle. I asked him if I could kind of go off of his pattern and make it my own. And he said, Buckin, of course you can. It's an axe handle. I said, I know, but I'm a man of my word. I don't just go grab somebody something or other and start copying it. I'm not that fella. So I'm just not that fella. Another company I want to shout out right now is Combat Abrasives. Friends, we're going into this thing, friends. We are going into this. Okay, this axe thing. I'm going to get a big piece of wood. We're going to set up our vise. We're going to be over at the other place. We're getting going. The press and the forge, that stuff's coming. I got a lot of setup to do, friends. I got to build the shop. And it's winter. This is what we're going to be doing. So I'm excited. Obviously cutting too, but this is exciting for me and everybody, I think. So we're going to produce some axes. It's going to be cool, amongst other things. So, but Combat, I went to try and buy some. I put an order and I went to their website, friends, Combat Abrasives. And he says, well, because he was in on the gift of this grinder, friends. Remember with Alex Steele and that? This thing? Remember when I got this gift from the boys, from Joe and Adam and all the rest of them, Callan and everybody at Alex Steele's and Garrett. Garrett was part of this. So he gave me these when I first got the grinder. So I'm running out. I'm thinking, okay, I gotta get some freaking abrasives here. I'm getting going on this. So I reach out to him and I go on his website and I make an order. Friends, like, I like their product, okay? The ceramic belts are deadly. So I'm like, okay, I'm the kind of guy, I get one, that's where I'm going. I don't need to go nowhere else. Well, I put an order in, right? I put a freaking order in, friends. And it didn't work. He wouldn't let me do it. He didn't let me do it. He said he refunded my money. Combat Abrasives. So friends, listen. He's a good guy, Garrett. Being a community type fella, friends, I want to support those guys too. So if you are in any need of abrasives, your belts, they do all kinds of stuff. Their product is good. I know it because I tried it, so I can now speak to it. It's good stuff. I loaded up on some stuff. Friends, he wouldn't let me pay. He knows I'm starting a business and he just, I don't know, it's just what he does. So that in my books is pretty wicked. So Combat Abrasives, I'll get a link. I'll stick it in the description. Why not? Go see them, Combat. Check them out on Instagram, Combat Abrasives. Would you guys do that for me, please? Would you guys, as a community, go in there to Instagram and Combat Abrasives and tell them Buck and Billy Ray said hi? Would you guys do that? Then at least he'll know I give him a shout because he's such a good guy. Let's do that, please. Anyway, I'm going after this by hand. It's kind of an interesting fit. Need to take much off, friends. I think I'm gonna switch this up. Yeah. we're getting close. I'm gonna show you this. Okay, so there we are. Excuse me. This is very interesting. And if you look, we have to be dead square from here to this, like right down square. And it looks good to me, friends. This is a different head. I haven't done one like this. And the back's got to be, this is where it's got the curl. You can see it. Look at this crazy curling it's got in here. See it? Can you guys actually see that? Oh, not in this light, you can't. There, see how it's chunking out? It's got figure. It's got like, this is actually gonna be an interesting piece. Interesting, actually. Yeah, look at this, look what they did. Will you guys see this? Probably not. Can you see this? I want to show you this. Yeah. See that? See that groove in there? Yeah, right there. See that? It's very interesting. Okay, let's take a look. Yep. Yeah, you can see right there what it's wanted me to do. Yep. I wonder if that's wood. It is wood. I gotta do some work to the axe head. Oh. Oh, it's that red stuff. It's epoxy. I can smell it. Give me a sec. Hey, Scotty Gagnon, again, brother. Like, come on. You know what I mean? Scotty Gagnon strikes again. I had to get in with the die grinder. I love you, Scotty. She's getting there, friends. Step by step. Oh. Oh, well. I'll be darned. Well, I think it's time to hammer this down. Cut a kerf in it and let it fly. It is top heavy, boy. I mean, I think these were sold on 36 inch handles. No, I'm gonna put it on this because I like it. That's why. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay. Yeah, you can see that sinew I see in it. Look at, can you guys see in here? Look.
Look at.
Yeah, see, I like this. I like this a lot. Yeah, so this will be interesting to swing. And this is what we're gonna do. Yeah, this is gonna be it, friends. This is it. This is what we're doing for now. I can always rehang it. It's a 30. Let's see. It's gonna be a 30 inch split nax. 29, 30 inch split nax, 5.5 pound split nax. Custom tool. Yeah. I got a new blade on that sucker. Look at that, friends. Look at that. Hey, dead square. I say that a lot, don't I? Dead square, dead nuts. Josh, nice job on them handles. Okay, so now let's quickly just do this. Gosh, that looks nice. It really does. And it hardens up the handle. Friends, this thing's ready to rock. I'm telling you right now. This is going to be a cool axe. Let's do it. I feel like putting a little edge on this right now, real quick. Give me a couple of minutes. I'm just going to put a little edge on this because it's beautiful. Maybe we'll just do it behind you guys.
It's a wood splitter.
It is time. There's some paint on it. Look at this, friends. Watch. So this is actually very interesting. Isn't that amazing? Wow. See, there's a groove I know it's there for a reason, but it's very interesting. That's cool. You hear that? I can hear the wood. I'm just gonna shine for that real quick. If you'll see the work, but it's a skinny little handle. I'll tell you that right now. Okay. You hear that, friends? Very interesting. Well, friends, it's time. I'm just gonna see what happens. This is a neat act, actually. I don't even know how this is gonna go. But I'm gonna slam this in here. I'm not even playing around at all. It's just going. Yes, it is. I can't believe how tough this stuff is. That was skinny. This stuff's crazy, friends. I mean, it's crazy. Look at. That's it. It's done. What a neat axe. That stuff's crazy. So you know what it is, friends? The axe head is bent. The blade goes like this. You see it lots, friends, in these big long blades. This is long. You can see it. It don't matter. It's a beautiful tool. Look at it, friends. HB. Freaking, I am stoked. I did not want this down any further because I want my length. Look at that. That is so sweet, friends. I'm excited. Johnny Holmgren. Here, I'll put it. That's a little chainsaw mill. Just leave it here. Okay. Thanks, babe. I forgot about that. Thank you. So, friends, this is actually very cool. It is a custom short-handled HB splitting maul. And I'm actually super happy how it turned out. I am. I don't know how much use it'll get. It's a gift from my good friend Johnny Holmgren. It's cool, actually. I love the French curve, friends. I do. I love it. And this is an older one. Because he actually, remember the other ones are thick here? This is cool. That's kind of why I left that like that. This is neat. What an interesting piece. I'm not doing, someone's bashed this, friends. That's why the freaking thing's bent. I guarantee it. Look at it, it's being bashed over. Look at it. Oh, it's bent. You can see looking at it, it's bent. It goes like this. That's funny. That is actually really funny. But anyway, I don't have really anything to split, friends, but you know what? That's not true. Why don't we? Because it's HB and the steel is like some of the best steel axes ever. I've got arbutus here, small arbutus. See in this wood cheddaronis? Why don't I grab a chunk of arbutus This stuff's nuts. See how small this piece of wood is? And how hard this... Look at this, friends. Wow. Actually, that's kind of nice. Oh, arbutus. It's a small piece of wood. It's a freaking quarter around. Watch this. Did you just see what just happened? Actually, a nice split knox. Pretty nice tool. Let's go check something out.